Welcome, dear student, in the Gurukul lectures. Today we will discuss about the carbon family. अभी तक हम नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी के बारे में बात करें हैं, उसके बारे में हाउ वी प्रिपेयर द नैनो पार्टिकल्स, हम नैनो पार्टिकल्स को सिंथेसिस कैसे करते हैं, हम नैनो पार्टिकल्स को कैसे डिफरेंट तरीके से बना सकते हैं, अभी तक हमने वो डिस्कस किया. वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन द नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी इज़ द कार्बन मॉलिक्यूल विच प्लेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी. सो इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कार्बन फैमिली इन विच वी डिस्कस द टू मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ कार्बन. वन इज द बकमिंस्टर फुलरीन एंड सेकेंड इज द कार्बन नैनो ट्यूब. बोथ आर एलोट्रोप्स ऑफ कार्बन एटम. सो हेयर वी आर सीइंग ऑन द स्क्रीन दैट द टू बॉल्स विच आर रिवॉल्विंग are the Buckminster fullerene, and the diagram in the center which is rotating is the carbon nanotube. So in the next discussion we will discuss about the Buckminster fullerene family and the carbon nanotubes. Now we know that the allotropes of the carbon atom, carbon are formed in the two forms, crystalline form and the amorphous form. In the crystalline form, we know that the allotropes of carbon atoms are diamond, graphite and fullerene. Diamond and graphite को आप सब जानते हैं कि पहले discovered हुए थे, and fullerene was the new element which was discovered in 1985. The fullerene is the third allotrope of carbon atom. So here we see in the diagram that this is the laboratory where this Buckminster fullerene was discovered. इस Buckminster fullerene को discovered के पीछे 1985 में scientist ने Buckminster carbon atoms particles का mass spectrometry लिया. मास स्पेक्ट्रोमीट्री से पता चला कि फुलरीन इज ए फैमिली ए कार्बन एटम विच इज हैविंग द मोस्ट ऑफ द कार्बन एलोट्रोप्स. C20 से C540 तक मॉलिक्यूल्स वर फॉर्म्ड इन द कार्बन नैनोट्यूब्स इन द कार्बन क्लस्टर्स. सो दिस ग्रुप ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट डिस्कवर्ड द Buckminster fullerene and they just got the Nobel Prize in 1996 for the discovery of the Buckminster fullerene. What is the fullerene? Basically, fullerene is made of entirely carbon atoms, and they form the sphere, ellipsoid and the tube. Sphere for the Buckminster fullerene, if we get the sphere, then we can say it is a bucky ball. The spherical structure of the fullerene form the bucky ball. The ellipsoid structure form the C70, and the tubes form the carbon nanotubes, or we can say it is a bucky tubes. So fullerene is formed from the all the carbon atoms in the form of sphere, in the form of ellipsoid and in the form of tubes. The most important are two elements, which are Buckminster fullerene and the carbon nanotubes. Then naming of the fullerene, why it is called a fullerene? Fullerene was named by the scientist or the architecture, we can say it is a Richard Buckminster Fuller who just given the architecture model of the soccer ball, or we can say is a geodesic dome, and this shape which is you are saying on the screen, which you are seeing on the screen, is a revolving ball. It is just like a dome structure, and this formed by the pentagons and hexagon, and the by name of this scientist Richard Buckminster Fuller, the Buckminster fullerene was named. And why it is and here we see that the shorter name is the fullerene. Fullerene is a family where we are having the carbon molecules from C20 to C540. And this shorter name fullerene is used to refer to the family of the fullerene, and this suffix "-ene", indicates that each carbon atoms are attached with the other carbon atoms by using the covalent bond. So it is called the fullerene in the word used there, the suffix used there. So fullerene, where all the carbon atoms are attached to each other by using the covalent bond, and this is the fullerene. And here we see the different allotropes of carbon atoms, and here we have a chart, the difference between these three allotropes of carbon atom. First we see the graphite, second is the diamond, and third is the fullerene. Then here in the chart we are having the diamond, who is having the hybridization sp3, and graphite and the fullerene having the sp2 hybridization. Our overall structure, here we are having the 3D lattice in the diamond, and similarly 2D in the graphite, and fullerene, all are formed in the form of the cage, and all the carbon atoms are arranged in a cage. And then bond length, if we see carbon-carbon bond length in the diamond, it is approximately 1.5, and here 1.3, here we are having the 1.40 to 1.44. If we talk about the electrical properties of three allotropes, then we see that that diamond is a insulator, and the graphite is a conductor, and the fullerene is an insulator. Fullerene is an insulator. The density, here we see that the density, how the density is changed from diamond to fullerene. So this is the comparison chart between the three allotropes of carbon atom. Now we are talking about the fullerene. These are the three scientists who discovered the fullerene molecules. The work started from 1985, and in 1996 they got the Nobel Prize. The three scientists' name are Curl, Croteau and Smalley, who discovered the Buckminster fullerene. Here we see in the diagram C60, where it C60 means Buckminster fullerene, which contains a 60 carbon atom, C70 which contains a 70 carbon atom. Here in the third diagram we see that there is something blue type of thing in between the fullerene. It means we can store an element in the fullerene also. And on the downside we are having the two round tubes. One is closed, that is the nanotubes, and this is a single wall carbon nanotubes, and second is, and it is closed at the one end by the fullerene, and second is the open ended fullerene tube, open ended carbon nanotubes. So these are all the parts of carbon clusters, and these are all the families of fullerene. These are all the elements in the family of the fullerene. Now our concentration is on the fullerene. Fullerene, basically the most prominent molecule in the fullerene is the C60, and it is found in the abundant quantity when we just did the experiment, just we find the discovery of, when we found the discovery of fullerene family, then C60 found in the most of the abundant quantity. And C60 is also called a buckyball. Why it is called a buckyball? Because of its shape. It's having a spherical clusters of carbon atoms which are arranged in the series of 5 or 6 membered rings. It means it is arranged in 5 carbon atoms are attached, and the 6 form the hexagon rings, 5 forms the pentagons rings, and these pentagons and hexagon rings are attached with each other, and they form the shape like a soccer ball. So Buckminster fullerene found in a spherical cluster form, which contains all the carbon atoms which are arranged in the 6 and 5 membered rings of carbon atom. Other here we see in the diagram, first two upper diagram is for the C60, and second is the C70. Other relative common clusters are also available in the family of the fullerene. Here we see that C70, C72, C74, C76, C78, C80, C82 and C84. It represents that all are having the carbon atom here. If we take the C82, it means 82 carbon atoms are attached together and form the C82 structure. and the plenty of others higher or lower than C60 exist in the fullerene family, but in the less abundant as compared to the C60 and C70. One thing we noticed here that all the carbon atoms are having the even number of, all the fullerene are having the even number of carbon atoms. Here we see C70 are the even number. So all the even numbers are or carbon atoms are arranged in the 5 and 6 membered rings and they form the soccer ball. These are the structures of other fullerenes in the family like C80, C82, and these are all form of the round shape. Some form in the soccer shape, some found in the rugby shape. So here these are the different structures of the fullerene clusters. These are also found in the fullerene family. Next, the most important, here we see in the formula C20 plus 2N, where 12 pentagons rings and N hexagon rings. N means N can be changed to form the various fullerene clusters. C60 and C70 are most prominent. C70N and C78 are shown. Here the coordination number are 3, or the coordination numbers for the 66 and C70. We can say it is 3 and they are having the sp2 hybridization in their structure. This is the fullerene structure C70 and C60. C60, as you are seeing on the screen, that it is like a soccer ball. Here on the left hand side, it is like a rugby ball. The C70 is having the ellipsoid structure. All are called the fullerene, but the C60 is called the Buckminster fullerene because of the name of the Buckminster Fuller. Here you see the rotating diagram of the C60. All the molecules are arranged in the pentagons and hexagon rings. But how many pentagons and how many hexagon rings are attached here? We know that 60 atoms are attached together to form the carbon molecule, the C60 molecule. Now see this is the allotropes of carbon atom, and this is the most famous fullerene in the C60, and it is discovered by the Croteau, Smalley and Curl in 1985, and they got the Nobel Prize in 1996, and the name was honor of the American architecture whose name was Buckminster Fullerene. So Buckminster is taken from the Buckminster Fuller, the popularly known as Buckminster Fullerene. The shape of C60, as we defined here, that it is resembles as a dome structure which is based upon the hexagons and pentagons, which is designed by the Buckminster Fuller. There are different types of the fullerene. When the fullerenes were discovered in 1985, then most of the evaluations have been formed in this fullerene. So there are some examples which the fullerenes were formed. One is a Bucky ball cluster, which was the first discovered and which is having the C20. This is the smallest member in the family, C20. The fullerene family starts from C20 to C540. And C20 is the unstable version of the, and this is the most common and the most common version of the fullerene molecule is the C60. And second type of fullerene is the nanotubes, which is of the hollow tubes and a very small dimensions and having a very small diameters, and it is in the form of single or multiple walls. Means nanotubes can be formed in the single wall and the multiple wall, and they are in the form of open and closed nanotubes. How we can say it is a open and closed nanotubes? As we are having the carbon nanotubes, that they, if we put the fullerene on it and we close it with the soccer ball like the fullerene, and then it will cover. So we are having two type of nanotubes. One is a closed or one is the open nanotubes, and these nanotubes are having a various applications in the electronic industry as well as in the biology industry. So nanotubes are of the two types, single and multiple wall nanotubes. Next type is the megatubes. These megatubes having a larger diameter than the nanotubes and is prepared with the wall of the different thickness. Potentially it is used in the transport of the variety of molecules of the different sizes. So these are different from the nanotubes, and these tubes are used to transport the molecules. It means we can put the molecules inside the tube. So these tubes are called the megatubes. Next is the polymer. We can also get the polymers by using the fullerene, and these are of the, these like the chain, and two dimensional or three dimensional polymers are formed under the high pressure and high temperature conditions. So polymer is also formed. Nano onions means spherical particle based upon onions. We are having a multiple layers. Similarly here we are having the multiple carbon layers in the nano onions, and which is surrounded by the Bucky cores. And this nano onions, which is formed by the buckyball cores, they are used as a lubricant. And other form is the linked ball and chain dimers. Ball and chain dimers, and the name suggests that two buckyballs are linked by the carbon chain and they form the carbon ring. We are having the two carbon structures and they are attached with the some molecules, and then it is a buckyball linked by the carbon chain, and they form the carbon rings. Structure of the C60, as it is a very important molecule, and its structure is truncated icosahedron structure. Its geometry is the truncated icosahedron. Icosahedron where we are having a polygon with the 60 vertices and the 32 faces that form the icosahedron structure. And this C60 molecules, we are as discussing that it is having a 60 carbon atom, which are arranged in the 12 pentagonal rings and 20 hexagonal rings. Pentagonal rings means where the 5 carbon atoms are attached. 12 pentagons ring where the 5 carbon atoms are attached, and hexagon rings where the 6 carbon atom attached and form a structure. So C60 is made up of 12 pentagons ring and 20 hexagon rings, and it forms a soccer ball like structure. A carbon atom is present at each vertex, and it is aromatic, it is aromatic, and the several resonance structure in its C60 in a truncated icosahedral geometry. Pentagons are separated by the heptagon and the hexagon. The isolated pentagons by the isocated pentagon ring rules. All the pentagons are separated with the hexagon, and they are automatically attached at the corners, at the upper and lower side of the soccer ball. The vacancies of the each carbon atoms are satisfied by the two single and one double bond. It means all the carbon atoms, all the hexagon and pentagon rings are attached in the form of two single and one double bond, and which is formed the sp2 hybridization. So we can say that in the C60 structure, single and double bonds are there to join the pentagons and hexagon rings to form the structure like a soccer ball. The fullerene cages are about 7 to 15 angstrom in the diameter and are one carbon atom thick. Diameter may be vary as the production of the fullerene, but its size is approximately, diameter is approximately 7 to 15 angstrom. Here the bond structure and the reactivity of the C60 fullerene. The bonding pattern of the C60 fullerene, we see in the diagram, the yellow bond represents the double bond and the red bond represents the single bond, and these hexagon and pentagon rings having the single and double bonds to form its band structure. And the pentagon rings contain only the single bands, while the double bands have a shorter bond length and lead to the instability in the pentagonal rings. Instability in the pentagonal rings, it means it will be easily attached with the other element. Another molecules can be easily attached with this pentagonal, with these double bonds. And these are having the shorter bond length and they are unstable. So, the limitations of the double bond locations leads to the poor delocalization of the electrons. And this will increase the molecule's reactivity because of the poor delocalization of the electrons or the double bonds because of the double bond. C60 is a phase-centered cubic lattice. Now, fullerene reaction, here we see in the diagram that the fullerene's reaction, the fullerene can be reacted in many forms. Means some molecules can be attached in it and that is the additions. It can be polymerization. The molecules and particles are formed and they form the polymers and they are attached with each other by forming a chain. So, fullerene reaction can be formed and fullerene can be formed in many types. Thank you.